Hello dear friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to talk about introduction of red and black trees in data structure. What are red and black trees? So a red and black tree is a binary search tree with one extra attribute for every node. That extra attribute is nothing but the color of that every node. The name itself suggests that the tree is red and black tree. That's why the color of every node will be either red or black. And to store the information about the color of every node, this one extra attribute has been added in every node. Now let's see the rules of red and black trees. So basically, red and black tree is a binary search tree. We can add one more feature over here, which is self-balancing binary search tree. Self-balancing, that I am going to explain in few of the minutes. And what is binary search tree? All of you must knowing a binary search tree. Binary search tree is nothing but a tree where every node in a left subtree of a root node is having a less value than the value of a root node, and vice versa, every node in a right subtree will be having a value which will be greater than the value of a root node. Now let's see, or let's go through the rules of a red and black trees. So we can say that the rule number 0, or very basic property of a red and black tree, is nothing but every node should follow the binary search tree property. I have given the number to this property as number 0 because unless and until your tree is not a binary search tree, we can't proceed for the next rules. So the first rule is, every node has a color either red or black. The next property is about root node. The color of root node will be always black. Always every root, the root of every black, red and black tree will be a black colored node. The next property is, there are two adjacent nodes will be there, but they should not be of the red color. Adjacent node means what? Every parent node and a child node are going to be treated as an adjacent node, and they should not be red. It means that if the parent is red, child should not be red, or if child is red, its parent should not be red. They should have different color than each other. So there are no two adjacent red nodes. The next property, every path from root to a null node has same number of black nodes. Now you need to keep in mind null node. Null node are nothing but the leaf node in red and black tree. So that null node, the number of black nodes from the root to the null node, the quantity or count of that black nodes must be same in every path. And the last property is, every leaf node are nothing but the null nodes, and the color of that node will be black. Now let's see the different examples of a binary search tree. And before that, we'll check or we'll go through how to identify red and black tree. If a tree is given to us and we need to identify whether the tree is red or red and black tree or not. So to identify this tree is red and black tree, whether it is a red and black tree or not, we need to go through different set of rules which we have just seen in the previous slide. So let's start. Whether the tree is binary search tree? Yes, the tree is binary search tree, where the left subtree is having the node whose value is less than the root node, and the right subtree having the nodes whose value is greater than the root node. Let's consider 15 as a root node. The value to its right subtree 25 is greater than 15. So all the nodes are satisfying the property of binary search tree. So the property 0 is satisfied by the given tree. The first property, whether the every node is red or black. Yes, every node is of the color red or black. So property 1 is also satisfied. Whether the root is of color black. Yes, it is also black. So this property is also satisfied. Does two adjacent nodes are of color red? Yes, these two nodes are there, both are having color red. That is, if the 15 is parent of 25, parent is also red, child is also red. In this case, two adjacent nodes are of color red and it's not allowed in our red and black tree. So all conditions are not true. The violated condition is the condition number 3. We can say that the condition 3 is false. Hence, the given tree is not a red and black tree. Now let's go for our next example. Now as far as the previous example is concerned, these two are the nodes who are adjacent to each other but having red color, and this property is violated. That's why it was not a red and black tree. But now here, the same example, only the color of 25, node 25 is black. So for the 0th property, it is satisfied. First also satisfied. Second is also satisfied. Third is also now satisfied, as there are no any two nodes who are adjacent with each other with the red color. Now let's check for a property number 4. That is, does the count of black nodes is equal in every path or not? Now let's check the count. Here is the first black node, second black node and third black node. Before going to the count, let's see how are we going to check how many paths are there. The number of nil nodes, 5 number of nil nodes are there. So that's why here we can say that 5 number of paths are there. The first path is 10, 5 and nil. Second path is 10, 5 and this nil, this right child as a nil. The third path is 10, 15 and nil. Fourth path is 10, 15, 25 and nil. And the last path is 10, 15, 25 and nil. So in first path, there are 3 black nodes, 1, 2, 3. In second one, 1, 2, 3. In third one, 1 and 2. Here only it suggests that, or it says that, it shows that in first two paths, there were the number of black nodes, 3 black nodes were there. But in the third path, there are only 2 black nodes. It means that the count is not equal, and we can say that all conditions are not true and the condition 4 is false, or this tree violates the property number 4. That's why it's not a red and black tree. Now let's go for a next example. Here in this example, let's check whether the tree is binary search tree. Yes, every node satisfies the property of binary search tree. Let's check, every node is either red or black. Yes, every node is either red or black. Whether the root is black. Yes, the root is black. In this property, we need to check only the root node, whether this one is black or not. Yes, it is a black. Let's check, does two adjacent nodes are having color red? No any adjacent node are having a red color. Go for a next property. Does the count of black nodes is equal in every path? So now let's check how many paths will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. In these 9 paths, now let's check how many black nodes are there in path number 1, 1, 2 and 3. Path number 2, 1, 2 and 3. Next one, 1, 2, 3. For next path, 1, 2 and 3. Next one, 1, 2 and 3. Next one, up till this, 2 black nodes, and this one is the third one. For a next path or in the right subtree, 1, 2 and 3. Next 1, 2 and 3. And the last one, 1, 2 and 3. Now you can see that all the paths, all 9 paths are having 3 number of black nodes. So, does the count of black nodes are equal? Yes, it is equal. Next property, whether the all leaf nodes, that is nil node, are black or not? Yes, they are black. All conditions are true. There is no any violation. And now we can say that given tree is red and black tree. Now let's go for a next and last example from this slide. Now this is the example given to you to check whether the property is satisfied by this tree or not. Let's check the binary search tree property. You can check now whether this tree is satisfying the binary search tree property or not. You can pause this video and check whether this tree is satisfying the binary search tree property or not. Next one, every node is red or black, whether the root is black, the adjacent 2 nodes, are they of color red, does the count of black node in every path is equal, whether the leaf nodes, nil nodes, are black or not. And after checking all these conditions, you can identify that there is no any violation in this tree. It means all conditions are true, and now we can say that the given tree is red and black tree. Now some are the more example. If we are having a chain of 3 nodes, but it's not possible in red and black trees. Now let's see how. If we are going to insert the numbers in our binary search tree in the sequence 30, 20 and 10, they will get inserted in a form like skewed binary tree. And if it is a skewed binary tree, this will not be the example of red and black tree, because it will violate the property number 4, that is the count of black node in every path will not be equal. Here 1, 2, 3 and 4 black nodes are there in the second path, again 4, but in third path there are 3 and in last path there are only 2 black nodes. Now let's go for if we'll make the middle node as a red node, where it satisfies the property, no, still it violates the property number 4. Now let's go for the if we want to reduce the number of black nodes, and we will make the node 10 as a red node. Will it now satisfy the property of red and black tree? No. Now here it violates the property number 3. So now here you can see that the skewed binary tree, that may be a left skewed binary tree or a right skewed binary tree. Here I have shown the example of left skewed binary tree. But if you will draw a right skewed binary tree, this will also perform the same task. And here, these three are not going to satisfy the property of red and black tree. But if we want to perform or we want to satisfy all these property, we need to modify the given tree in these two possible ways. Where the 20 will become a root node. If 10 and 30 both are of the color black, then it will be okay, because the property 4 is going to satisfy over here. That is, number of black nodes are equal. And if we are going to make these two nodes as a red node, here again the property is going to satisfy all the properties. There is no any adjacent red nodes are there, as well as the number of black nodes are equal. So it satisfies the property of red and black tree. Now why red and black tree? Here you can see that the maximum time complexity required will be big O H or big O N for the skewed binary tree if the height H is there and a number of elements are there. But in red and black tree, the time complexity will be big O log N. Why? That I am going to explain in my next lecture. Please stay tuned for the next lecture. Thank you.